أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين جزاكم الله خير وبارك الله فيكم and does Allah خير the viewers who are watching us from any place and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make all of us get benefit of that inshallah. We're still with the حلقات في التوحيد and the part of it now about being thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Last time also we take hadith in al-Bukhari volume number 4 hadith number 3464 and 6653 volume number 8 and in Muslim 2964 about the leper and the bald-headed man and the blind one. That Allah tests them with being poor and need, then with being also rich, with being sick, and also with being healthy. That means that the test for them was two kinds. Actually more than two kind, but in general with two things. Firstly, Allah tests them while they are sick, and Allah changed their case to healthy and was poor, and Allah changed it to them to be rich. Then Allah sent to every one of them an angel looks like same of what they have before. He went to the leper man with a disease in his skin and looks poor, and he said to him, I'm poor, and Allah give you all of this, give me one in order to reach my destination. He, instead of being thankful to Allah and first step to recognize and admit, the favor of Allah on you, he said, No. All of what you say is wrong, because he said to him, the angel, I think he was before same of what I am. He said, No. I was rich already and I inherit all of this from forefathers before and this and that. He denies the favor of Allah. Number one, you have to recognize the favor of Allah in you. Admit it, do not deny it. Then be thankful to Him. And being thankful, not only kissing the hand, this is nothing actually. There is a way. At least use it, and I will say how to be true thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the pillars of being thankful. I'll explain it inshallah. Then he went, the angel Allah went and make him to go to the bald headed man, and he also goes to him with the same, looks poor and looks also bald headed man, and he, because this was their request from Allah, oh Allah, remove what the sickness we have and make us rich. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers them. For the first one, the leper man, Allah give him a lot of camels, valley full of camels. The second one, valley full of sheep. The third one, I think cow. And cow. And the third one was a blind man, valley full of sheep. First and second one, they deny the favor of Allah upon them, and they didn't give nothing, and they rejected, and they claim lying that it was, we have that before. The third one, the blind man, is the one Allah was so happy with him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was be pleased with him, and we ask Allah to be pleased with us, and we ask Allah to accept our own good deeds and make us real thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then, I ended with arkanu shukri and ni'am, pillars of being thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What it is? Number one, al-i'tirafu wal-iqraru bi-ni'mati Allahi azza wa jalla alayk. To admit and to recognize. Recognize the ni'mah, what it is. And actually, every single thing you have, favor of Allah upon you, grace of Allah upon you, ni'mah of Allah upon you. For that, recognize it, admit it, never reject it, never deny it. This is number one. And this is a way of being, submit yourself to the way of Allah. خُضُوعٌ وَذِلَّةٌ وَمَحَبَّةٌ. Who is love? Because when you do not know the ni'mah of Allah upon you, the grace of Allah upon you, and you are ignorant about it, or you never think about it, you will never be thankful to Allah. جزاك الله خير. You will never be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about it. But when you know it, when you know it, then second step will come. When you recognize it and you know the ni'mah of Allah, نِسْبَتُهَا إِلَى الْمُنْعِمِ. You have to return it and to know who give it to you. When you know the favor of Allah and you recognize it, but you don't know who give it to you, which it is Allah Azza wa Jal, you'll never be thankful to Allah. When you know it, and you know the one who give it to you, which it is Allah, but you deny it, or you reject it, or you belie it, or you think that because of your own merits, and because of your own intelligence, then you'll never be thankful to Allah. But whoever knows the favor of Allah upon him, whoever recognize it, whoever admitted, and who know who give it to him, which it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he admit it, accept it, does not deny it, but still لم يخضع لله ولم يحبه, does not submit himself to Allah, and does not like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he does not be pleased with Allah, then he will never be thankful also. When you will be a true thankful to Allah, أداء حق الله في النعم وبذلها فيما يحب. Listen carefully. Pillars of being thankful to Allah. Number one, عرف النعمة. Recognize and admit the favor of Allah and the grace of Allah upon him. Look to it, what you have. Instead, only look to what you don't have. No, look to what you have firstly. Recognize it, admit it, accept it, be happy with it. Then number two of the pillars, عرف المنعم بها. He knows who give it to him, which it is everything in your hand coming to you from Allah Azza wa Jalla alone. When you know who give you this grace, it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you admit it, accept it, do not deny it. وأقر بها ولم ينكرها. Accept it and he does not deny it. Like the other people, the bald-headed man and the other one in the hadith, they deny. The liber man, they deny the favor of Allah upon them. If you deny, you will not be thankful to Allah. But when you accept it and admit it and believe that this is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, does not deny it, وَخَضَعَ لِلْمُنْعِمِ بِهَا وَأَحَبَّهُ. And he submit himself to Allah and he love him. وَرَضِيَ بِاللَّهِ وَرَضِيَ عَنْهِ. And he be pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and pleased with him. Then Allah will be pleased with you. وَأَدَّى حَقَّ اللَّهِ فِيهَا. And he do the right of Allah in it. Right of Allah in it, number one, there is no doubt is zakah. For that at the time of zakah, do the zakah. But not only is zakah. وَفِي أَمْوَالِهِمْ حَقٌ مَعْلُومٌ لِلسَّائِلِ وَالْمَحْرُومِ. In their money there is a certain haqq and it is known for the one who asks and for the one is prevented, the poor people. But there is other huquq in your money for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاسْتَعْمَلَهَا فِي مَحَابِ اللَّهِ. Then he used it for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, for obeying Allah. Because when Allah gives you a gift and you use that gift in disobeying him, Allah gives you a car and instead of coming to masjid, you use it for other than Allah. You use it for disobeying Allah. Then, this is if you are like that, you know the favor of Allah, you recognize it, you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know that Allah is the one who gives it to you, then you accept it and you do not deny it and you submit yourself to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you be pleased with him and you be pleased upon him and you do the right of Allah in it, and you use it for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal and for the obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are now the true thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Missing of anyone of that, you will not be thankful to Allah. If you don't know it. Instead, if you know it, you don't know it. If you know it, but you deny it. If you do not deny it, but you do not accept it. You do not submit yourself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are not happy with Allah. You will not be thankful to Him. You accept it and you know it and you يعني, submit yourself, but you don't want to do the right of Allah in it. You are not thankful to Allah. You want to to do the right of Allah in it, zakah and some other things, but you do not want to use it for the sake of Allah. You do not use it for the things Allah love, for obeying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Still you are not thankful to Allah. But if you have all of this, then you are real thankful to Allah. فلا بد في الشكر من علم القلب وعمل يتبع هذا العلم. Number one, you have to know by your heart, by your mind, what is the grace of Allah on you. Then actions, by giving it for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. وهو الميل إلى المنعم ومحبته والخضوع له. To be love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be submit your will to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to be thankful to Him of whatever Allah giving you, little or much. Because some people, they will be thankful with whatever much, but not thankful with whatever little. And this little may be in your eye only. But if you compare yourself with others, you'll find whatever little in your eye, a lot for some other people. Ibn al-Qayyim said, الشكر ظهور أثر نعمة الله على لسان عبده وعلى قلبه وعلى جوارح. He said to be thankful to Allah by three things: by your tongue, by your heart, and by your body. How? By your tongue, ثناء واعترافا, being thankful to Allah and being admit the ni'mat of Allah upon you and being praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and being thankful to Him with whatever He giving you. How? By your heart. شهودا ومحبة. Love of Allah by your heart. When you love Him and submit your will to the will of Allah, this is thankful to Allah by your heart. How? By your جوارح, by your body. When you use your body for whatever Allah love and prevent your body from whatever Allah doesn't love. This is a complete and perfect and a true thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah mentioned in the Quran al-Karim in Surah Ibrahim saying, Surah Ayah number 7, لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَازِيدَنَّكُمْ. If you are thankful to Allah, Allah will give you more. That means one way to increase the grace of Allah upon you to be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Thankful to Allah. You remember what the angel in the hadith we take last time said to him when he denied? He said to him, if you lie, I am asking Allah to return you to whatever you was before. Means being poor and being sick, instead of being healthy and wealthy. Because he what? He does not be thankful to Allah. Allah say, لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. You are thankful to Allah, I'll give you more. Because Allah loves you to be thankful to Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then He will increase barakah of whatever you have. And He will give you more of whatever you like. Because Allah knows your nature. Be thankful. There is another hadith about being thankful also. And I'll bring it, inshallah, later in Silsila Sahiha 667. And Imam Ahmad in Bayhaqi number 4 in Bazar and other. مَنْ لَمْ يَشْكُرِ الْقَلِيلِ لَمْ يَشْكُرِ الْكَثِيرِ. Whoever not being thankful to the little, he will never be thankful to the much. If you are not thankful to whatever little you have, when you have a lot, also you, because it's a nature. وَمَنْ لَمْ, in the same hadith in Sahih, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَشْكُرِ النَّاسِ لَمْ يَشْكُرِ اللَّهِ. Whoever not be thankful to the people, he will never be thankful to Allah. It become a nature. Look to yourself. Are you thankful to Allah when it is little or not? Some of the people very high degree, even there is no little, there is no at all. Even while they are sick, they still be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They will say when you ask them, say Alhamdulillah. Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is very high degree. But that does not come only from the tongue. No, it comes from their deep heart, from the roots of their heart. Mindful, they are, know that this is even the sickness. One of the awliya used to say, Wallahi inna lanafrahu bil masa'ib farahukum bin ni'am. He said, Wallahi, by Allah, we feel happy of the calamities equal to your happiness of the graces of Allah. Because they know everything from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they never be, because when you are not thankful, you are angry with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They never be angry with Allah. They always thankful to Him, love Him, submit your will to him, because you know everything is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Allah said in Surah Saba, ayah number 13, warning us. Be thankful, because little of my ibad will be thankful. Allah said, وَقَلِيلٌ مِّنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُورِ. Qalil means few. Of my ibad, even not from the people. Allah does not say qalilun min al-nas. Even from the worshipper. Few of the worshipper will be thankful to Allah. Subhanallah. For that, be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is warning us, saying that qalilun, there is difference between qalilun min al-nasi shakur wa qalilun min ibadiya shakur. Min ibadi. Allah say, few of my slaves, few of my worshipper will be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That means even including some of the worshipper, he will not be true and perfect and complete, thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Maybe yes, he thanks Allah, but should not, it is not as it should be done. It is not as it should be done. Look how many favors of Allah upon you. Because some of the people, cup of water, half of it water, half of it empty. Some of people, they will be thankful to Allah that there is water. Even half, alhamdulillah. Some of the people, they will never ever see the water. They will see, so look empty, the complainers. Some of people always complain about the whole world. And this is the one who will not be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allahumma a'inni ala dhikrika wa shukrik wa husnu ibadati. Oh Allah, help me to do perfect and complete and as should be done dhikruka, remembering you, ala dhikrik wa shukrika, and being thankful to you, complete and perfect, to be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa husnu ibadatik, and doing your ibadah as it should be done, with the best way. There is no doubt, best way according to the Quran of Allah and according to Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also, in Surah Al-Insan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say two ways. Inna hadaynahu sabil. Imma shakiran wa imma kafura. Ja'ala muqabila al-shukr. Al-kufr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, inna hadaynahu, we show him the way. Either being thankful or being unthankful, ungrateful. Allah make in front of shukr kafura, which it is not the kufr will get you out of the Islam, but still Allah named it kind of kufr, because kufr, when you deny the favor of Allah upon you, this is kind of rejecting the ni'mat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for us to be always thankful to Allah for whatever happened to us from him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And believe me, wallahi, if you reach to that high level, you will be so happy. Because nothing will bother you, right or wrong. You will be all the time happy, all the time pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Never be angry. And also will be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah will give you more. As he said, he promised. And who can be and fulfill his promise more than Allah? Allah, when he promised, say, if you be thankful, I'll give you more. More barakah, more rizq, more of the same kind, more of other kind also. Not only the human being, even Iblis, he knows that high level of shukr. Iblis himself, the one who disobeyed Allah and he said, I'm not prostrate myself to Adam. He knows maqam shukr, that high level of being thankful to Allah. In Surah Al-A'raf, ayah number 7, he said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ثم لآتينهم من بين أيديهم ومن خلفهم وعن أيمانهم وعن شمائلهم ولا تجد أكثرهم شاكرين. He said, I'll come to them from front, from back, from right, from left, in order not to make them thankful to Allah, because he knows that high level of being thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very appreciated by Allah. For that he target one of the most important. He said, you will not find, ya Allah, majority of them not thankful to you. Also wrong that Allah Azza wa Jal giving you everything and being thankful to other than Allah. Allah is the one who gives you. Then instead of being thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you start being thankful to the people. Oh, this man is the one who did it for me only, and this man is the one who helped me in that. We are not denying that he helped. But who make him... sorry for that. Who make him to help you? Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For that he have no favor. You should not see any favor of him upon you. It is actually Allah. But being thankful to him is not wrong. But you should be thankful to Allah. He's the one who make him submitted to you and helping you and aiding you and supporting you and him and you under the will of Allah and by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you grace from him, any kind of grace of money, grace of health, grace of wealth, grace of also position, because when Allah chooses you for doing something for him, is from Allah Azza wa Jal, and you should be thankful to Allah when it. But this is if you do it as it should be done. Anything, if Allah open to you a gate of helping the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do not delay and do not hesitate. This is a grace from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For that, do not close that gate. Do not prevent the people from the way of Allah. Never ever do any wrong to nobody. Also, do not try to, you don't want it and you don't want others to do it. No. If suppose you are not able for any reason, ask Allah forgive. But let others and try to, tell the others about it, to do it. Also, if the grace of Allah coming to somebody and Allah make you a reason, do not prevent it. Because Allah doesn't like that. If Allah make you a reason of some goodness, this is some of the goodness and should be reached to so and so through you. Do not prevent it. Do not say, no, he doesn't deserve it. Ya akhi, subhanallah. For that this is one of the ways to be thankful to Allah. That it is from Allah to ibadullah. Do not prevent it. Do not close the gate. Also, try to make all of the things around you, of any grace of Allah around you, for obeying Allah. And for... with a direct way for da'wah, for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. You love yourself, you should love the people. And love for the people, whatever you love to yourself. Love for the people, whatever you love for yourself. Don't fear except Allah Azza wa Jal. Sometimes will come to your mind, oh, if I do this, this will happen. Everything in hand of Allah Azza wa Jal alone. Because the same people, you try not to make the da'wah for them, they will come in front of Allah blame you. He was between us. And he never told us nothing. Then you will be punished because of that. In dunya before akhirah. If you are able, then you prevent yourself. Use the wisdom. I'm not saying that go all of a sudden, do the wrong and commit mistakes and you'll be fired from your job. No. There is too many ways other than that. Too many ways to do da'wah. Being honest and being straight and being good. I'll give you a different example. Selling wine is a good example. If a Muslim... selling wine, or if they are drinking, then you drink with them, wal'iyazu billah. This is calamity. This is now preventing the people from the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not by tongue, but by action. But when you are a good example, and you are far from the haram, and you try to do the halal, and you attract the people to it, even without saying nothing, all of us knows Islam spread in India, Islam spread in Pakistan, in Bangladesh, in all of Asia, and majority of the Muslim world now. How? Not by talking only, by the real and true practice of Islam, right or wrong. By being honest and being good and being mercy to the other people. Because we think that da'wah is only by talking. No, it is one of the way. And it is explanation of the Islam and also answering their question and defend Islam, especially with the wrong they say about it, is good. But also your own practice and your own behavior is very important. Because when you behave bad, this is actually not being thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For that, submit your money, submit your time, submit your position for the sake of Allah azza wa jal, for calling the people to Allah. And use your mind, use your wisdom. How I do that? With the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, inna Allah يُحِبُّ أَنْ يَرَى أَثَرَ نِعْمَتِهِ عَلَى عَبْدِهِ. Allah loves to see the traces of His grace upon you. Allah gives you a lot, then you hide it. You are rich, then you try to appear in front of people that you are poor. Time of sadaqat, you don't want to give, and I need, and this. Amazing, ya akhi. Subhanallah, this is actually denying. Denying the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you. Some of the people, alhamdulillah, excellent, when you go to them, and right away, they give more than whatever. But some others, subhanallah, not only they prevent themselves, they try to prevent you from doing that, which is wrong. Why? This is what I'm saying. Do not prevent yourself. And at least if you are not able, do not prevent the others. Some of the people, they talk to me, oh, don't do it, and this. And say, Ya, subhanallah, you don't want, we are not forcing you. Right or wrong? It is voluntary. But let us open the gate for the people. Rasulullah himself asked the people to donate for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. And he went to the ladies and he asked them. And it is a hadith in Sahih Bukhari that the ladies take out their ring and take out their gold and take out their bracelet and give it to Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Bilal actually is the one who was holding his clothes and they put everything in it. For that, as long as it is in Islam, there is nothing wrong with it to encourage the people to obey without forcing anyone you want to do. But I'm saying do not prevent and do not try to make them look bad and look down. And in this hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in Sahih 667, whoever not being thankful to the little, he will never be thankful to the much. And whoever not being thankful to the people, he will not be thankful to Allah. وَالتَّحَدُّثُ بِنِعْمَةِ اللَّهِ شُكْرٍ. And being talking about that, without denying, talking about the favor of Allah upon you, itself is shukr. وَتَرْكُهَا كُفْر. And leaving it and denying it and rejecting it is kind of ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالْجَمَاعَةُ رَحْمَةٌ. Being united is a mercy. We ask Allah to unite us. Ramadan is coming. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for us to be united, and we ask Allah to save all masajid from the problems of the Muslim in Ramadan. Because look to Ramadan, you'll find majority of the troubles and the problems and created by Muslim inside the masajid. After Ramadan finished, all kind of things finished. Then start next Ramadan, same problems again and again. Fear Allah Azza wa Jal. Need to be also the shuyukh and the imams in their masajid. Talk about that. Come to the masjid of Allah in Ramadan and other than Ramadan with peace mind. And if suppose there is a problem, try to solve, be part of the solution, not to be part of the problem itself. And you put gas in it and you increase it, then you go to this and you go to that and push that one and talk about A'udhu Billah. A'udhu Billah. From my experience, the last many years, the percentage of the problem increased in Ramadan. Why? I don't know. Subhanallah. Find the whole year in a lot of masan. Very peaceful and everything going on, and there is little here and little there. Come in the Ramadan, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-ali al-azim. Amazing. Instead of we are fasting and we are reading Quran, and shayateen is tighted and should be very peaceful and should be very good for everybody, and everybody enjoy it and call the others to come, no. Find opposite of all of that. And this is not, they will claim shayateen is tighted. Shayateen is just chained. Subhanallah. But shayateen, al-ins, not chained. They be more active in Ramadan. We ask Allah to save us. My advice, for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, very, very humble request. You have some problems in Ramadan, keep it yakhi till after Ramadan. Because when you start in Ramadan itself and some other around you and group agree, group does not agree, then here, then there, then it become more and more and more, then some people professional put some guys over it. Ya akhi, subhanak ya Rabbi. Subhanallah. Wallahi, I am talking from experience. In many masajid. And if you don't believe, think about the masjid you are in. You will find that really percentage of the calamities and the problems and the fighting will be higher in Ramadan, which it should not be at all. And especially more and more at the end of Ramadan. From the last 10 days of Ramadan, see what's happening in every masjid. Subhanallah. This is need, every single one, without exception, to help. Talk, instead of talk to each other about the problem, talk to each other, please, brother, cool it down. Don't talk about it now. If everybody doing that, the shayateen of the human being, they will not find a ways. They will not find a place. But when everybody keep quiet and it's not my problem and turn your face, and then it will be more and more and more, and then they will find their own helpers. Jama'ah is rahmah. Being united is a mercy from Allah. وَالْفُرْقَةُ عَزَابٌ. And being divided is azab. We are in this azab these days. Being divided, not only countries, because all the time they think about countries divided. No. Wallahi, even inside the families, inside the communities, inside our own masajid, we are divided. Why? Far away from Quran of Allah, far away from the Sunnah of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and I want all of my right, and I don't want to give you nothing. You want your right? Give him his right. You want him to be merciful? Start with being by yourself, being merciful. If every one of us start by himself, then see what I can do, what I can help, instead of criticizing and blaming, and oh, do this and do not do that, and in giving orders to the people, start with your own self to do the right. Then everything will go very well. Everything will be united by this way. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as I said in khutab many times, unity is the duty of every Muslim and Muslimah. It's not a duty of one. One cannot, two cannot, three cannot. Impossible. It's the duty of everyone, man or a woman, to be love and really the one. Even from between hundreds of thousands, one, two people doesn't want, it will never be affected. But if the majority doesn't want, and only one wants it, doesn't matter who is he. The only one can really unite the people by his power is Allah Azza wa Jalla alone. And Allah will do it when he finds the people want it. When we work for it. When we love each other. Forgive each other. Do not criticize each other. Do not blame and backbite each other. Then it will be going very well. Sahih Muslim. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَرْضَى عَنِ الْعَبْدِ. Look to this hadith. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَرْضَى عَنِ الْعَبْدِ يَأْكُلُ الْأَكْلَةَ فَيَحْمَدَهُ عَلَيْهَا وَيَشْرَبُ الشَّرْبَةَ فَيَحْمَدَهُ عَلَيْهَا. Allah will be pleased with his slave. When he eat anything, then he say, Alhamdulillah for it. And when he drink anything, then he say, halal. Then he say, Alhamdulillah for it. But when after you eat and after you drink, then you criticize. Actually, criticizing the food is not the way of Rasulullah. We take it before. One of the ways of Rasulullah Sunan, of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He loves the food, he eat it. He does not like it, he never criticize it. Never. Doesn't matter what it is. You like it, eat it. You don't like it, don't criticize it. We like it, and we eat it, and we eat too much of it, and after it, we criticize the people who do it. Ya akhi, subhanallah. Wallahi, amazing. I see sometimes some of the things. You already eat a lot of it. And I see you myself. Then, you bring again and again. Then at the end of things, Alhamdulillah, and Jazakumullah khair. No, it should be having this and it should not be having that. Why he did this with that and this is so and so. Then you start criticizing too much after already he finished. Then is there a sweet or no? Subhanallah. Then Allah will be pleased with somebody who is. When he eat, he'll be thankful to Allah. Then when he drink, then he'll be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ولذلك سمي الشكر الحافظ للنعم والجالب لغيرها. الشكر named being thankful to Allah, named this is the protection for the things, for the grace of Allah upon you, protection for it when you are thankful and bringing more. سمي الشكر الحافظ للنعم والجالب لغيرها. The title for الشكر is the one who protects the by the will of Allah. Protect the ni'mah you have. Allah will keep it for you as long as you are thankful to him. And Allah will give you more. Abu Dawood wa Tirmizi. Kana Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Iza ja'ahu amru sururin. Aw bushra bihi. Kharra sajidan shakiran lillah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? In Abu Dawood wa Tirmizi. When any glad tiding coming to Rasulullah about something good happen, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what he do? Huh? He prostrate himself, being thankful to Allah, and named sajdatu al-shukr. Like Sayyidina Dawood in Surah Sa'd, Rasulullah named it sajdatu shukrin. Sajadaha akhi Dawood shukran, wa ana asjuduha shukran. Rasulullah s.a.w. say about the sajda of Surah Sa'd, that my brother Dawood did it as a shukr for Allah, for that I am doing it as a being thankful. for the ulama saying that should be done out of the prayer, should not be done inside the prayer because of Rasulullah named it not recitation sajda, it is thankful sajda for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Surah Az-Zumar, ayah number seven, وَإِن تَشْكُرُوا يَرْضَهُ لَكُمْ. If you are being thankful, Allah will be pleased with you. In the first one, ayah I read, Allah will give you more, and Allah will be pleased with you. In Al Imran, ayah number 144,
وَسَيَجْزِي اللَّهُ الشَّاكِرِينَ.
Allah will reward the thankful people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, thankful people, Allah will reward them. And actually Allah count being thankful to Allah from al-ibadat. One kind of ibadah. Listen to Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah number 172.
وَاشْكُرُوا لِلَّهِ إِن كُنْتُمْ إِيَّاهُ
تَعْبُدُونَ. Be thankful of Allah if you are worshipping. For that he named that shukr, kind of ibadah. تَعْبُدُونَ is coming from ibadah. Shukr for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah by His great name to make us very thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To number one, to recognize and accept and admit the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to know that this is from Allah alone, not from anybody else. Then never deny it, accept it and never deny it. Submit yourself to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be pleased with Allah and be pleased with Him subhanahu wa ta'ala for whatever He do of decision subhanahu wa ta'ala. And know that everything happened to you is ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even you like it or you don't like it. Some of the calamities is a favor from Allah to you. Allah prevent you from something. And this something you like it. You think, oh, why Allah prevent? Allah prevent you for some reason. And from some wisdom. And from you, anything happened to you is a favor from Allah, but you don't know. Sometimes you will know the reason behind it and the hikmah, the wisdom. Sometimes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't give you the wisdom. But you should know that all of the actions and af'al Allah behind it some hikmah. All of it without. There is no any action for Allah without wisdom behind it. There is wisdom. Either you know it or you don't know it. Be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and be pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Addi haqq Allah fi al-ni'am. Do the right of Allah upon the favor of Allah upon you. It is belong to Allah from beginning and belong to Allah from the end. Allah is the one who gives, and Allah doesn't want to keep it with you, Allah will not. For that, be thankful to Allah from the same thing He gave it to you. You are not bringing something from your own. It is the favor of Allah, and when you give it back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by being thankful to Him and doing the right of Allah upon it, this is the way to be thankful to Allah, and also istamilha fi mahabbillah. Use it for being thankful to Allah and for the things Allah love, not for the things Allah hate, not for the things haram, not for the things is Allah give you cars, use it for the masajid, not use it for going to haram places. Allah give you anything you have of the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know the computer very well, use it for the sake of Allah azza wa jal. As I said many times, internet instead of full of garbage, if the Muslim, if every Imam, I told the Imam that many times. Fill it with the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even you say, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, record it and put it. At least this minute, taken in a place of another minute, bad. Right or wrong. Again with another way. Look to the good stuff in the internet and the bad stuff on the internet. If the good stuff is more, and especially about explanation about the Islam and the true picture of the Islam, not whatever they put against Islam. And this is must be done by the Muslims. Then it will be a chance for some people to know more about Islam, to know good side, which Islam, all of it is good. But I mean, instead of knowing whatever they lie against Islam, they will know the truth of the Islam. For that, use it for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. When you do that, you are true and complete and perfect, thankful to Allah. If any one of that missing, you don't know the favor of Allah, you will not be thankful to Him. You do know that Allah is the one who gave it to you, you will not be thankful to Him. You do not accept it or you deny it, you will not be thankful to Him. When you do not submit yourself to the will of Allah, you will not be thankful to Him. When you are not happy with Allah, you will not be thankful to Him. When you do not do the right of Allah upon the thing you have, write off Allah of zakah or sadaqat or whatever, then you are not thankful to Him when you do not use it for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jalla and for the things Allah love and for the things beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for obeying Him, then you are not thankful to Allah. We ask Allah by His great name to make us always thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we ask Allah by His great name to save us from being ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we ask Allah by His great name to make us shakir and give us more, and give us the reward of being doing like that. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to admit us to Jannah and save us from the nar. Allahumma ghafir lana dhunubana wa kaffir anna sayyatina wa tawaffana ma'al abrar wa a'inna ala dhikrik wa shukrik wa husn ibadatik ya dhal jalal wal ikram. Allahumma ahdina wa ahdi bina wa ja'alna sabal liman ihtada wa arihna wa farihna wa asturna wa la tafdahna. Nas'aluka bismika al-a'zam yassir lana umurana wa shrah lana sudurana wa ghafir lana dhunubana wa kaffir anna sayyatina wa tawaffana ma'al abrar wa a'inna ala dhikrik wa shukrik wa husn ibadatik. ونسألك باسمك الأعظم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لما اهتدى ويسر للمسلمين الدعاء لنا بكل خير يا رب العالمين. اللهم إني أسألك وأسك الله by His great name to remind every Muslim and Muslima to do dua for us always, and to do dua for forgiveness for all of us inshaAllah, and to admit us to Jannah and to save us from النار. اللهم ولي أمورنا خيارنا ولا تولي أمورنا شرارنا وولي علينا من تحبه وترضاه وولي من يصلح ويصلح يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. صل اللهم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وجزانا وجزاكم الله خيرا.